Hot off the press, Wahoo have just announced the KICKR bike at Eurobike. Let's jump straight to the promo video they've released on it.
This one's for the obsessed. A training machine built for cyclists by cyclists. The goal, blur the line between virtual and reality. And this is the result. KICKR bike. A complete training system designed to recreate what you experience on your outdoor bike. You're fit. Your kit. Your set. Your rides. All built on everything we've learned since we launched our first revolutionary creation.
And you all thought they were releasing a watch. Okay, while we're in shock and all, let's go through the tech specs of this new smart bike, smart trainer. So, power accuracy plus or minus 1% with no calibration required, power up to 2200 watts, grade simulation plus 20% down to negative 15%. So they've taken the stationary bike and made it less stationary. Noise is virtually silent, it's belt driven. The Groupset function can simulate Shimano Di2, SRAM and Campagnolo, that is fully customizable. I'll go into the details in a moment. Gearing simulation, again, fully customizable. There's a status indicator on the bike showing grade, gearing and connectivity. The cranks on the KICKR bike allow from 165 to 175 crank length with all those 2.5 mil increments in between. The adjustability and fit, well, it's quick adjustable. There's a full setup guide and it's made for multi-riders. We'll go through more of that in a moment as well. Customization, you can put your own bars, saddle, stem, pedals, and TT or tri-bars on the KICKR bike. Connectivity, AMP+, AMP+ FEC, and Bluetooth Smart, so supported by everything. And the data transmitted is speed, power, cadence, and obviously trainer control. It's an interactive smart trainer. The KICKR bike has downhill grade simulation, so the flywheel will spin over if you're in sim mode going down a negative gradient, and the braking works both back and front, so you can stop that flywheel from spinning, or if the software you're using supports braking, there you go, you've got some interactivity. Okay, now catching my breath on a few things now, and my take on what we've just seen. Well, first of all, they've kept this under wraps very, very well. No embargo leaks, no one really saw it coming, there was a few guesses around, but that's it. Wahoo now make a smart bike. It's out and known. I've ridden an early version of this a little while ago, and the one thing that jumped out to me on this bike was the gearing and the gear changes. Now, on a belt-driven smart bike, sometimes it's hard to differentiate between a gear change, which makes things a little harder to pedal, and a simulation grade change, which makes things a little harder to pedal as well. So they're one and the same. It was a bit confusing. With the KICKR bike, when you change a gear, you get that slight jolt knowing that you've changed a gear. It feels like that. It's one of those, oh wow, they got that part right moments when I was riding this unit. There's a lot to discuss when it comes to the customization of the KICKR bike, and I think that's quite important if you're spending this kind of money on this kind of bike. You want it to be your bike with your fit. You don't want to be feeling like you've just wheeled a spin bike out of a spin studio and taken it home. You want that experience to be just like riding your bike with your fit. So as such, the adjustability of it is quite extensive. As mentioned in the tech specs, you can swap out all contact points as per your preference. So your bars, your stem, your saddle, your pedals, whatever you like to make it your bike and your fit. If you want to go to the next level, I'd be putting a set of carbon bars on there, not for the weight savings, but if you're sweating buckets indoors, you don't want to be sweating over some alloy bars. So I'd go a carbon stem and carbon bars if you're sweating buckets and have some spare buckets of cash for that. There's provision to add even more shifters on the KICKR bike as it stands. So a future upgrade will be for the triathletes, Ironman, time trialists in this all to put those bars on with some shifters out the front. Alternatively, you could put a pair of mountain bike bars on there, maybe even a dropper post if you get creative. More on the customization, and as I said, there's a lot to talk about here. The gearing, you can configure the gearing as you please. If you can think about it, you can configure it. The crank length options, as mentioned, quite unique. Weight isn't a problem indoors, so they can fit the bike with this crank set. And you've got the options to maybe even try out different crank lengths if you want. There's no physical steering of the KICKR bike, but there are enough buttons on the front which can be utilized by any software to provide almost any functionality. So for example, on the inside, there's some thumb buttons, which you can use to turn left or turn right. Okay, more details on the setup and the configuration. Now, this is important to cover because it's got to be a seamless experience taking this out of the box. Yes, it comes in a box, not on a pallet, so you don't need specialist equipment to get it into your house. That experience needs to be straightforward and just work every time. And in particular, the bike fit has to be correct. So they've put a lot of effort into the onboarding. There's an app that will take you through the experience with animations and just showing you how to get it done. Once you've assembled, powered up, and paired the KICKR bike, there are three options to get your fit exactly the same as your bike that you ride. First of all, if you've had a professional fit done from, say, Guru, Retool, or Trek, you'll get a set of numbers at the end of those saying they're your fit numbers for your bike. You can just enter those numbers in and it will spit out how to configure the KICKR bike for that exact setup. Secondly, you can take a photo of your bike. Now, bear with me, this does work quite well. So the little app has some smarts built in. You put your bike up against the wall, stand back, take a photo. There's some interactivity for it, then you measure your wheelbase, and again, it will spit out some numbers for you to configure your KICKR bike, which will get you pretty close to accurate. Or the third option is to enter your height and inseam length, and it will give you a few options to get you riding close enough to where you need to be. The shifting configuration on the KICKR bike is quite unique. You can replicate any group set that's out there at the moment. So we have Shimano Di2 or mechanical to choose from, SRAM ETAP, SRAM mechanical, or Campagnolo. How that works is the same muscle memory. That's what they're focused on. So for example, SRAM mechanical, you press and hold to replicate pressing in a little further for SRAM mechanical, or ETAP up and down, same as ETAP outside. Campag, you've got those inside thumb buttons as well. There are 5 buttons per lever each side plus the brake, so I'd call that 5.1 buttons. Plus, in the future, there'll be more to add for those TT bars. There is presets for the gear ratios, but you can customize that if you like, and up the front, you can go virtually 1x, virtually 2x, or virtually 3x. Okay, almost wrapping this one up for today, and more on the value of this unit. Now, at $3,499, that price tag is high, but again, referring back to when we went from dumb trainers to smart trainers, there was a jump in price of a few hundred dollars to over $1,000, but the value that provided us and the experience on bike and for the training, it was much better, so the value matched that. Smart bikes, we don't quite know just yet if that price tag is gonna match the experience. On paper, it looks pretty close. So in summary there, I think the value add for this bike is it has tilt, so it's not just a stationary bike. That onboarding experience looks to be pretty seamless. We will cover that in the near future. I have one en route to the Llama Lab next week. And the ability to customize that bike looks pretty neat too. So there we are, the Wahoo KICKR bike announced today. They're the details. Stay tuned for my ride experience. Hit subscribe to be notified when that's released. All right, thanks for watching.